Hi, in the previous lecture we have been talking about the drag force. It is the force an object feels when it moves relative to a fluid. In the sheet we see a quick overview of what we found. The drag force is proportional to the frontal area of the object and to the stagnation pressure. The constant Cd in the expression is the drag coefficient. It is not a constant, but actually a function of the Reynolds number. In today's lecture we will focus on the drag coefficient. Cd depends not only on the Reynolds number. It is also different for objects of different shapes. It is virtually impossible to find Cd by deriving analytical solutions from the flow equations. Only for low Reynolds numbers and simple shapes like a sphere is this possible. It was Gabriel Stokes who found an analytic solution that is now known as Stokes' law. It gives the drag force on a sphere for low Reynolds numbers smaller than 1. It reads as the drag force is equal to 3 pi d mu times v. Stokes found that exactly 1/3 is due to drag form and exactly 2/3 from shear drag. Note that the density of the fluid does not play a role. It is the viscosity that is important. If we compare Stokes' law to the general expression for the drag force, we find that for the case Stokes investigated, the drag coefficient Cd is a simple function of the Reynolds number. In formula, Cd is 24 over Reynolds. Let's do an example using Stokes' law. Why do raindrops fall and fog droplets float? The answer to this question is both fall, but the fog droplet with a rather low velocity. Let us calculate the terminal velocity of a fog droplet. We know that it's a tiny water droplet with a diameter of about 10 micrometer. Calculating the terminal velocity means that we set the sum of forces equal to 0. These are drag, buoyancy and gravity. We assume that the drag is given by Stokes' law, to be checked at the end of course. Thus we set the sum of forces to 0 and use our formula for gravity, for buoyancy and for Stokes' drag. Next we solve the terminal velocity from this equation and put in numbers. We find a terminal velocity for our fog droplet of 2.7 centimeters per second. We should not forget to check whether we are allowed to use Stokes' law. So we compute the Reynolds number. It is 0.016, indeed much smaller than 1, and the use of Stokes' law is justified. Conclusion. Fog droplets do fall, but at a very low velocity. With this example we conclude our lecture on the drag force. Good luck with the exercises until next lecture.